Packages are used to avoid naming conflicts and to organize code files into different directories. The code file here is currently not included in a package and therefore belongs to the default package, as can be seen in the project's window. If we take a look at the source file using Explorer, we can see that the default package simply means that the file is located at the root of the project's source directory. To move the file into another package, we can create a subdirectory here with the name we want for the package, and then physically move the source file into that folder. When we now return to NetBeans, the project's window will update and display the folder as a package containing our source file. In addition to moving the file, we also need to specify that it belongs to the new package using the package statement. There may only be one package statement in each source file, and it must be the first line of code, except for any comments. Packages can also be created from inside of NetBeans using the project's window. This time, we'll create a sub-package under our first package, which will be called sub. Note that levels in the hierarchy are separated by dots and that the naming convention for packages is all lowercase. To this package, we'll add a public class called MyClass. Now, to access MyClass from our other source file, we have two options. We could either type the fully qualified name, or we could shorten this notation by including the class with the import keyword. These import statements must be located before all other members in the code file and simply frees us from having to type the fully qualified name. In addition to importing a specific class, we can also import all types inside a package using an asterisk. Note that this does not import any of the sub-packages. A third variation of the import statement is the static import, which imports all static fields of a class so that it can be used without having to specify the class name.